Our reflection meditation words for today are written by Maureen Killoran, entitled, Let Us Tell Stories of Mothers. Let us tell the stories of mothers, stories that could be true. Let us tell of warm mothers, soft and round, likely to be found with flour on their nose, and always ready to pour you a glass of milk to go with the cookies on your plate. These mothers are increasingly rare. Let us tell of mothers who are like bubbles of champagne. They surprise your senses, leave you giggly, but when you least expect it, they erupt with an unexpected bop. Stories that could be true. Then there are grouchy mothers, stressed mothers, exhausted mothers, faces lined with worry, spirits tired and gray. Other mothers are wise and reliable, not prone to many words or to a lot of noise, but you know that when you need them, they will be there. Let us tell of fierce mothers, the ones who love you even when you're wrong. Let us tell also of absent mothers, whose memory shimmers at the edges of your heart. Let us tell of distant mothers, loving mothers, giving mothers, save the world mothers, the too busy mothers, mothers that make you cry because you lost them, mothers who make you cry because you can't. May we hold in our hearts the mothers we have known, those who loved us, and those who tried. May we forgive the mothers who didn't get it right, and try to release the knots of disappointment, anger, grief, and pain. May we hold in our hearts the truth of that mothering, nurturing. That is a task that belongs to us all. However old or young you are, whatever your gender, may you make extra room for nurturing in your life this week. May you say something to a real harried store clerk, or give a coworker a genuine compliment, or take time to listen deeply to a friend. In our shared silence, may we remember and reflect and create anew the stories of love and nurture from this point forward. Stories that can be true. Martha will be passing out some accessories to this next musical interlude.
Everybody gets to participate today. Have an instrument, you can start playing it. That's fine. Yeah. Just don't hurt anybody.
Thank you for that enthusiasm. I invite you to bring that enthusiasm or that joy or reflectiveness into our ritual. This is the reason you all have the flowers. At the closing of this reading, I'll invite you to process up and place flowers in this vase over here. You can hold on to those musical instruments. We'll collect them. You can drop them in the basket on the way back. Just one logistical fact. This is Honoring the Bouquet of Our Mothers by Judy Wells. Today we pay homage to our mothers, the women who birthed us and watched us grow, wiped our noses and stuck Band-Aids on our knees, kept their fingers crossed that we would turn out all right. Throughout this ritual, we will arrange a beautiful bouquet as varied as our own mothers, grandmothers, and foremothers. See how unique they are, how different from one another. What an impressive array. Each flower is here to remind us about a particular person and the indelible impression they made on our lives. Some mothers are like Forsythia, spilling over the neighbor's fence, almost unbearably cheerful, energetic, and determinedly curious, insinuating themselves into our lives. Some mothers are like daisies by the side of the road, humble, perhaps a little frayed around the edges, fretting as they pick at their clothing. Some mothers are like irises, informal gardens, austere and complicated, holding themselves back as we try in vain to discover what's really inside. Some mothers are like roses displayed on a trellis, lovely, sweet-smelling, sure of their favorite place in our hearts. Some mothers are like thistles in a field, their sharpness wounding as we try to get close. Some mothers are like violets coming up in the lawn, unassuming but tenderly loyal, always there regardless of how we take them for granted. Some mothers are like ivy on a brick wall, holding us too tightly, unwilling to let us go. Some mothers are like beds of peonies, bosomy, overdressed, embarrassing us with their lavishness and the lipstick marks they leave on our cheeks. Some mothers are like lilac bushes beside the kitchen door, welcoming, familiar, reminding us that we can always come home again. Living or dead, perfect or flawed, gorgeous or plain, they are mothers and they did the best they could. Our feelings about our mothers are probably as complex as this arrangement that we will put together in a moment. Let us love them for what we can love in them and honor them the best we can, flawed as we are too. From them we were given the gift of life. Let us say thank you each in our own way as we honor this day. I invite you to come up through the middle, row by row, place your flower in this vase, and as you see, it's next to the joys and concerns, Mike. If you would like to share the name of the mother or maternal figure that you're honoring, you're invited to do so. Please come forth. This year. So as you can see, while I don't have children of my own, I have loved the honor of working with the children of this congregation. And I find it appropriate that we're wrapping up the RE year in a month in which our theme is creativity. In our Waves and Reefs class, we've taken a deep dive into the water ecosystems of South Florida through the lens of our seventh principle, which honors the divine creation of the natural world and or the generative beauty of natural science, depending upon how you choose to look at it. We've learned that the interdependent web of life is all about creativity, in which organisms, big and small, are always adapting to their environments. In our Activism in Action course, I've worked with the middle and high schoolers of our congregation to survey an array of social justice movements that play a role in our city of Miami. The teens have come to appreciate how the world is continuously asking for creative solutions to the issues we face. Whether speaking truth to power through your voice, your vote, or your art, even the littlest members of our communities can have a big impact. It has been a joy to collaborate with these families throughout our RE programming. And building a family is an act of creation. The art of crafting a chosen family is one mastered perhaps most by individuals of the LGBTQ community, because historically, our kind of love hasn't always been celebrated. We've gotten really crafty in building relationships and orchestrating support systems that stretch well beyond the confines of a traditional family. In our present social climate, it is all the more precious that this community at UU Miami affirms that, as this book illustrates, it is love that makes a family. And all different kinds of folks can have chosen families too. As a matter of fact, I encourage it, especially to our little ones here with us today. I encourage you to look for love and support in your friendships, with your neighbors, from trusted adults like teachers. We've celebrated today the powerful and precious impact of mothers and maternal forces, who, by the way, are some of the most creative beings on this planet, some by necessity, others by gift. I wish I was as creative as Tiffany, for instance. But we've stated several times today already that maternal energy, that mom feeling, might come from all different kinds of places. That's the thing about chosen families, about scooting an extra chair or two at the dining table, about informally adopting some extra folks to your bio family. Through that process, you get to creatively reimagine what a family looks like. We can rewrite the rules to ensure that we as individuals feel both held and free to express ourselves in our chosen family networks. And those networks are, to use our word of the year in Waves and Reefs, interdependent. That process of deconstructing and reconstructing what the family system looks like is an act of revolution. In a world where it might seem easy to put things into neat and tidy boxes, it can be transformative to color outside of the lines. We change and grow when we are surrounded by all different kinds of people. I know that I have been changed for the better by becoming part of this UU Miami family. I know that my eyes have been opened and my heart has been warmed by taking part in this co-created faith community. And because of our creativity inherent in this unconventional pseudo-family system, I know that you will be resilient to the change in my role here too. As I've shared with many of you already, my decision to step back from the DRE role has been a tough one. Especially challenging because of the bonds I have with so many of you. But as with any pivot point, we come together with love and to strive for creative solutions. With that, I thank each and every one of you, especially the little ones, for making this year in RE so enriching and fun. Thank you for choosing me to be part of your chosen family.